गाइस हाय हेलो नमस्ते आदाब सत श्री अकाल अस्सलाम वालेकुम वणक्कम एंड खम्मा घनी टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम गाइस, वेलकम टू टुडेस क्लास. एंड एज यू ऑल नो, टुडेस क्लास इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड वेरी अमेजिंग क्लास. एंड दिस इज योर प्रोडिजी सीरीज फॉर सीबीएसई 10th. एंड द टॉपिक वी आर डिस्कसिंग टुडे इज अर्थमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन. नाउ अर्थमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन, एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू अर्लियर ऑल्सो, इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक बिकॉज दिस विल बी देयर इन योर हायर ग्रेड्स एज वेल. So in your grade 11th and 12th, this topic is there in the main topic sequence and series, which is there in your JEE examination as well. So those who are thinking of taking science and maths, very important topic for all of you. All right. So if you all remember, this is the second session. In the first session, guys, we have discussed about nth term of an AP. Today we are discussing about some of n terms of an AP. So we are going to solve some amazing questions. Some beautiful questions and some questions which will be of HOTS category, and you'll find them so easy once you start understanding the questions. So if you'll be in this session till the end, guys, I'll make sure that you'll be able to solve all different types of problems which are related to sum of n terms of an AP. All right. So without wasting any further time, let me introduce myself, guys. So my name is Gopal Paliwal. I am Master Teacher of Mathematics here at Vedantu. I have been teaching from the past 5 years and I have done my graduation from IIT Dhanbad, and other credentials you can see on my screen. All right. Theek hai bachcho. Now, this is a homework question which I gave you in the previous class. What this says, the fourth term of an AP is 11. How do I write fourth term? Fourth term is 11. So it can be written as A plus 3D. Is equal to 11. All right, first equation using general term formula, a plus 4 minus 1, 3 into d. All right, next thing, a fifth term plus seventh term is equal to 34. Right fifth term, it will be a plus 4d. Right seventh term, it will be a plus 6d is equal to 34. You have got 2a plus 10d is equal to 34. Take 2 common from both the side, cancel it. So you'll get a plus 5d. If you take 2 common from here, a plus 5d, shift 2 in division there, 34 by 2 is 17. This is my second equation. Equation 1, equation 2, both we have. Let's use linear equation in two variables, right? So I have a plus 5d is equal to 17 and a plus 3d is equal to 11. If I subtract both the equation, minus, minus, minus. So A got eliminated. 5D minus 3D is 2D. 17 minus 11 is 6. So D is equal to 3. Alright. So I can say common difference is equal to 3. If they ask you what is the first term, put D equal to 3 in any of the equation. Alright. And you'll get your first term as 2. Theek hai? So A will be 2, D will be 3. So our correct answer, common difference is equal to 3. Alright, now this question, let's see who are our homework stars, who has given the correct answer for this question. So we have Alaknanda KV, Nikhil N, Shivanand Nayak, Shankar Narayan, alright, Teddy Gupta, Sunita Dubey, Skrutha Devi. Alright, so these are all the students. So very well done, guys. Huge round of applause from my side to all of you for giving the correct answer. Other students, guys, please also, you also start giving your answer for the homework question so that you can also come in this homework stars. All right, guys. So let us start the class now. Now, as I've told you, this session we'll be talking about some of n terms of an AP. And there is one more session planned, which will be for applications, in which we'll be discussing word problems. All right. Now, by the end of this session, you'll be able to this question. S5 plus S7. Now you must be thinking, what is all that? Don't worry, I'll make sure I'll tell you everything about it, and then this question will be very easy for you. ठीक है, चलो शुरू करते हैं क्लास को. First thing, sum of n terms of an AP. देखो अब क्या हुआ ना, sum of n terms of an AP ना, let us try to understand it with the help of an example. Let's say I have given you an AP 1, 2, 3, 4, and this way 96, 97, 98, 99, and 100. ठीक है, यहाँ पे 5 कॉमा कर लो. Alright, this is an AP. 1 to 100, all numbers are in an AP. Every time plus 1. अब बेटा, what I saw that if I take the first term and the last term. If I will take the first term and the last term, and if I add these two, 1 plus 100, my answer is 101. Yes or no? Yes, sir, correct. Same way, if I add second term and second last term, 2 plus 99. Again, my sum is what? 101. Alright. If I take the third term from the starting and third term from the end, in that case, 3 plus 98. So, it is again going to be 101. So, you can clearly see that every time the sum is remaining same. 4 plus 97 is again equal to 101. Alright, 5 plus 96 again equal to 101. So every time the sum is 101 only. Now, if I try to see how many such pairs are possible, they go, one pair is 1 and 100, 2 and 99, 3 and 98, 4 and 97, 5 and 96. So this way I can say ki sir, total 100 numbers are there. And I am making pairs of 2. First, last. So in this way, total 50 pairs would be possible. Hai na? Total 50 pairs like this will be possible because total 100 numbers are there. 1, 2, 3, 4. So in 50, it will be over. So I can say 50 pairs are there in which sum is every time, sum of one pair every time is 101. So I can say total sum, 1 plus 2 plus 3, if I add them till 100, I will say it is same. They go 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 and then 97, 98, 99, 100. Everything we are adding, if I add all these 50 pairs, each pair has sum as 101 and there are total 50 pairs. So you will get your answer as 5050. Okay? This is one amazing way of finding out the sum of n terms of NAP. Okay? So it is said, beta, that this has been discovered in this way by Gauss. Alright, that is why we call him father of AP. Okay, so you can see over here, sum remains 101 every time and total 50 pairs would be possible. Sum of all the terms will be 50 into 101, which is 5050. Now, taking this method only forward, and let's see how can we get the formula for sum of n terms of AP. It is very logical, very logical it is. Okay, let us say, guys, I have an AP. All right, क्या है AP? A plus D, A plus 2D, all right, and then this way, just a second, since I'm getting sum, now let me add them, it would be better, ठीक है, A plus 2D, A plus 3D, and this way, we are going up to, देखो, last term will be a plus n minus 1 into d, a plus n minus 1 into d, before that what will be getting, a plus 1 less n minus 2 into d, before that a plus n minus 3 into d, and so on, right? So this is my terms of an AP, these are my terms of an AP, and let's say I want to add them. I want to add all of them. Okay. All these will be added. So again, beta, if I apply the same logic, first term, last term, second term, second last term, third term, last term. If I will do the sum in that way, and let's say we got to know there are total n terms. Yes or no? I can say over here very well that in this AP, there are n terms. Alright, so if there are n terms, I can make n by 2 pairs. Okay, let's look at the sum of the first and the last one. So if I will add a plus n minus 1 into d, you got 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay, then we have next time a plus d plus a plus n minus 2 into d. So, dekho beta, a plus a will become 2a एंड डी प्लस एन माइनस टू इंटू डी। तो एन माइनस टू, इफ आई टेक डी कॉमन, इफ आई टेक डी कॉमन, यहां पे थोड़ा सा ध्यान से लिखना बेटा, डी प्लस एन माइनस टू इंटू डी, इफ आई टेक डी कॉमन आई एम लेफ्ट विद वन प्लस एन माइनस टू, एंड वन माइनस टू इज वॉट अगेन डी इंटू एन माइनस वन ओनली, सो अगेन इट विल बी टू ए प्लस एन माइनस वन इंटू डी। सेम वे इफ आई टेक द थर्ड टर्म एंड द थर्ड लास्ट टर्म, योर सम इज अगेन टू ए प्लस एन माइनस वन इंटू डी, सो दिस वे द सम विल रिमेन सेम, एंड आई नो देर विल बी एन बाई टू पेयर्स, तो सम ऑफ ऑल दीज टर्म्स। नाउ इन दिस एपी बेटा देखो, आई एम राइटिंग दिस सम ऑफ एन टर्म्स, आई एम राइटिंग सम ऑफ एन टर्म्स, आई एम एडिंग एन टर्म्स, सो दिस सम ऑफ एन टर्म्स हाउ डू वी रिप्रेजेंट इट विथ एस एन। एस रिप्रेजेंट फॉर सम एंड एन रिप्रेजेंट दैट स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम फर्स्ट टर्म यू आर एडिंग टिल एन टर्म्स, स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम फर्स्ट टर्म यू आर एडिंग टिल एन टर्म्स, सो आई कैन से सम ऑफ एन टर्म्स विल बी सर टोटल देर आर एन बाई टू पेयर्स एंड ईच पेयर सम इज टू ए प्लस एन माइनस वन इन टू डी। दिस इज योर फॉर्मूला फॉर सम ऑफ एन टर्म्स ऑफ एन ए पी, दिस इज योर फॉर्मूला फॉर सम ऑफ एन टर्म्स ऑफ एन ए पी। वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर्मूला बच्चों, वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर्मूला, मतलब डू नॉट फॉरगेट दिस एट एनी कॉस्ट। ठीक है, दिस इज योर फॉर्मूला, एस एन इज इक्वल टू एन बाई टू इंटू टू ए प्लस एन माइनस वन इंटू डी। ऑलराइट गाइस, ठीक है, दिस इज योर सम ऑफ एन टर्म्स, सो इज इट क्लियर व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एस एन? अंडरस्टैंडिंग द मीनिंग ऑफ एस एन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट इज अंडरस्टैंडिंग द मीनिंग ऑफ एस एन। एस एन मीन्स, देखा ध्यान से अगेन सुनना, एस एन मीन्स ए वन प्लस ए टू प्लस ए थ्री अप टू ए एन, एंड इट इज इक्वल टू एन बाय टू इंटू टू ए प्लस एन माइनस वन इंटू डी, दिस इज योर सम। ठीक है, अब वन मोर थिंग बेटा देखो, आई नो कि सर एवरी टाइम व्हाट आई एम डूइंग कि एवरी टाइम व्हेन आई एम मेकिंग द पेयर फर्स्ट टर्म लास्ट टर्म सेकेंड लास्ट टर्म थर्ड लास्ट टर्म, व्हेन आई एम डूइंग दैट एवरी टाइम द सम इज दिस ओनली ए टू ए प्लस एन माइनस वन इंटू डी, दैट इज फर्स्ट टर्म प्लस लास्ट टर्म, एवरी टाइम फर्स्ट टर्म प्लस लास्ट टर्म, फर्स्ट टर्म प्लस लास्ट टर्म। ठीक है, तो आई कैन से दैट सर फर्स्ट टर्म लास्ट टर्म सम इज सेम एज सेकेंड टर्म एंड सेकेंड लास्ट टर्म, थर्ड टर्म एंड थर्ड लास्ट टर्म, सो दिस फॉर्मूला कैन ऑल्सो बी रिटर्न एज एन बाई टू इंटू बाई दिस टू ए प्लस एन माइनस वन इंटू डी इज नथिंग बट फर्स्ट टर्म प्लस लास्ट टर्म, फर्स्ट टर्म विल बी ए लास्ट टर्म दैट इज योर एंथ टर्म, बेटर देन लास्ट टर्म आई वुड राइट ए एन बिकॉज इफ आई एम राइटिंग सम ऑफ एन टर्म्स आई विल एड अप टू एंथ टर्म। ऑलराइट, सो सम ऑफ ए प्लस ए एन, ठीक है, दिस इज वन मोर फॉर्मूला। सो व्हेन यू नो द फर्स्ट टर्म एंड द एंथ टर्म, इवन इफ यू डोंट नो द कॉमन डिफरेंस सम यू कैन डायरेक्टली गेट, अंडरस्टैंड दिस थिंग। द सेकेंड फॉर्मूला इज इंपॉर्टेंट इन दिस वे दैट इफ इन अ क्वेश्चन आई गिव यू द फर्स्ट टर्म एंड द एंथ टर्म, सो विदाउट फाइंडिंग आउट कॉमन डिफरेंस यू कैन गेट द सम बाय डूइंग एन बाय टू इंटू ए प्लस ए एन विल बी सम ऑफ एन टर्म्स। ठीक है बेटा, ओके गाइस, सो दिस इज हाउ वी कैन फाइंड आउट द सम ऑफ एन टर्म्स ऑफ एन एपी। ऑलराइट, सो वी हैव गॉट टू फॉर्मूलाज, वन इज Sn is n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. The other is n by 2 into a plus an, Sn. Now, I have told you Sn means what, beta? Remember, this is very important. Sn means a1 plus a2 plus a3 up to an. If I give you, suppose, S10, it will be a1 plus a2 plus a3 up to a10. If I give you S 100, it will be A1 plus A2 plus A3 up to A 100. So always, every time I will start from the first term till the nth term. It is very important. Alright, now this is one question. Let's look at this question, what this question is trying to tell us. This question says that if the sum of first n terms is 3n square plus 5n, find its common difference. Okay, what it is saying? Find its common difference. So if Sn is given to me as 3n square plus 5n, one thing which is very important and I want all of you to understand is that, ki sir, if Sn is given in terms of n, and if I put different values of n, I will get different sums. If I put n equal to 100, I will get sum of 100 terms. If I put n equal to 50, I will get sum of 50 terms. So what if I put n equal to 1? If I put n equal to 1, I will get S1, which is sum of 1 terms. So starting from first term, add up to 1 term. So that is A1 only. Right? So S1 is equal to A1. Very important relation which you need to remember, that S1 is equal to A1. Very important, beta. Don't forget this. S1 is equal to A1. I'm highlighting this so that you'll remember. S1 is equal to A1. If I put n equal to 1 in Sn, what I get is the value of S1, and S1 is nothing but equal to A1. Theek hai? So I can say if I put n equal to 1, I will get the value of S1, which is equal to A1. What it is? It is 3 into 1 square plus 5 into 1, which is 3 into 1, which is 3 plus 5, which is 8. So I got to know from this that A1 is equal to 8. Now let's go for the second thing. Second thing is n equal to 2. Second is what? N equal to 2. Alright, beta. So in this, if you'll see carefully, if I have n equal to 2, understand this in this regard. Okay, sir, if I write n equal to 2, S2 will be equal to A1 plus A2. Yes or no? A1 plus A2. Ab A1 plus A2, put n equal to 2 over here. That is S2. So 3 into 2 square plus 5 into 2. 3 into 2 square is what, beta? 2 square is 4. 3 is 12 plus 10, which is 22. So I got S2, which is nothing but sum of first two terms. A1 plus A2 as 22. I already know that A1 is 8. So in this, A1 plus A2 equal to 22. If I put A1 as 8, A2 is equal to 22, you'll get A2 is equal to 22 minus 8, which is equal to 14. So you can clearly say, sir, A2 is 14, A1 is 8, common difference will be A2 minus A1, which is equal to 14 minus 8, which is equal to 6. How amazing this question is, right? Without giving you anything, without giving you like first term, common difference, they have just given you Sn in terms of n, and you can find out now everything about this AP. You know first term is 8, you know the common difference is 6. Once we know A and D, we can find out anything about this AP. So a very good question. Very, very, very good question. Right, guys? Now moving ahead, beta, as you all remember, see what we have done till now, we have learned the sum formula in an amazing way. We have understood the basic of this topic. It's not like you're simply giving the formula and ki haan chalo solve karo. This doesn't work every time. If there is one interesting story behind it, there is an interesting way in which it can be taught, that will obviously generate the interest of the students. And when you have felt interested, you start liking the subjects. As yes, do you agree or not? And when you start getting interest in any subject, you start liking the subject. So it doesn't matter whether it is difficult or not. You don't like a subject because a subject is easy. Many times the easiest subject will be like, yaar, it is a very boring subject. But sometimes the many students find it very difficult, but you start finding it very interesting, because you start understanding it, you find interest in that subject. So it is very important that to make any student who is maybe right now not able to cope up with their studies, it is very important to generate interest in you. Once you will get interest in knowing things, once you'll start understanding things, then your this curious mind will ask you questions, then you would want to learn more. So that is how you start your studies. All right, so first generate the interest. That is the work of the teacher. Second thing, when the interest will be generated, the student will start knowing things. Then when the students once start to know things, human is very curious by nature. So your curiosity will make you tend you to ask more questions. What if this happens? What if this happens? What if that happens? So that makes you more say mathematically inclined mind it will take you towards. Okay, you will be more mathematically inclined, you will think logic, you will think about science, all these things will tend to happen, and this is a very general process. So this once it starts happening, then there is no look back. There is never a look back ki are yaar maza nahi aa raha. Everything you are going to learn in a fun and amazing way. Alright, so we know this pedagogy with which like the subject can be made interesting, and that is why we are like welcoming all of you to join Vedantus Pro subscription, guys. And first thing, let me tell you very clearly, it is the most reliable course, most reliable source for getting your studies, for trusting someone with your studies, because this gives you Vedantu improvement promise. This promise gives you guaranteed improvement. Yes, you heard me right, beta. With this promise, you get guaranteed improvement. That means improvement ki guarantee. So now it is not only your responsibility, but with you, we are also in this journey, and we give you guarantee ki beta, you come, you join, you study with us, and we'll make sure you will improve in your marks. If you don't improve, listen to me very carefully. If by the end of this year, if you don't improve in your marks, take your whole course fee back without any questions asked. That's the guarantee we are providing you. Only thing we want you, that once you have taken the long-term course, you should attend minimum 75% of the classes and 75% of the tests. That is our small, small condition. Now it is very less. It is not like, sir, why, sir, if it is guarantee, why this condition? Dekho bachcho, obviously, just paying for the course will not make you guarantee for the improvement. You cannot buy education, right? So obviously, your hard work will be required. What we are doing is we are also coming with you. It's not like everything on you. We are joining hands with you and we are saying, beta, if we both of us will work together, you will definitely improve. That is why this small condition, and that's once you start coming to the class, guys, you'll wait for the class. It criteria is very less. It is only kept so that sometimes very brilliant students also, they might tend to miss a class, maybe because of say internet issue, maybe some personal reason, something or the other. That is why this criteria is kept over here. All right, guys. So now, what are the different features you get? So you get plenty of features like unlimited classes, all right, interactive replays, quiz, test, assignments. Most important is doubt solving in the class. So when you are studying in Vedantus class, beta, you know that if you are getting a doubt, right? So it's not like you have to hold your doubt till the end of the class and at the end you can ask, you know? Not like that. You have got a doubt, ask it as it is. Ask it at that moment only. Now at that moment, when you're asking your doubt in the doubt panel, behind the doubt panel, we have amazing set of class teachers, highly knowledgeable in their subject knowledge, highly knowledgeable. All right. And they'll make sure that each and every doubt of yours will be answered. That is their responsibility. So other than master teacher, we have extra teachers in the class just to take care of your doubts. And this can clearly show to you how much we care about your doubts. I was telling you at the starting, curiosity, right? That's what we want. That is why we have kept extra teachers just to take care of your doubts. So your doubts are solved in the real time. You don't lose your focus in the session. All right. Then there are micro courses, crash courses to complete your syllabus whenever you want, to study your topic whenever you want. So all this is available to you at a very less price, beta. The link for the registration is mentioned in the description box of this video, as well as in the pinned comment, and the coupon code is GPE Pro to get 10% off. This coupon code will give you extra 10% off, and this will be the minimum price at which you will be getting this course. So let me show you very clearly, guys, that how you can register for Vedantus Pro subscription. Let's say you'll go to this video over here. Once you have gone to this video, in the description box, here you can see in the comment section, subscribe to Vedantu Pro. Now this link is given over here. Let me minimize myself. Yes, so here you can see subscribe to Vedantu Pro now, and in the description box also you can see register for Vedantu Pro subscription. Just click on this link. Once you click on to this link, you'll be taken to this page, grade 10 CBSE 2022, right? Now click here on change if you want to change your grade or board. Now you have three options over here: Pro Lite, Pro Classic, Pro Plus. Now let me tell you one thing for all of you to be very clear, beta. The classes will be same in all the three courses. Classes are common for all. So it's not like different classes. Classes are same. The only difference is the post-class experience. After the class, how much personalization you require. In Pro Lite, you get live classes, test series, assignments, notes, and doubt solving in the class. In Pro Classic, you get doubt solving after the class through mobile app. So even after the class, anytime you are getting any doubt, you can ask that on the mobile app, on the doubts app, and you will get solution for it. And in Pro Plus, you get doubts app as well as personal mentor. So personal mentor, you can think of them as your coach, trainer, guide, supporter, motivator, teacher. Any doubt, academic, non-academic, any problem you are having, you can always reach out to them, to your personal mentor, and they will make sure they'll be helping you, and they'll be making this difficult journey of grade 10 a very smooth experience for all of you. Now the prices of these three courses are different based on the features. You can try any of these courses for 1 month. The price, if you want to try it for 1 month, click on try for 1 month. You can only try it for 1 month. After that, you have to go and buy a complete course. But if you will be like, sir, I cannot pay this all together, then what can be done? Don't worry, guys. When you click on buy complete course, EMI option is also there. So that will be like for you, that will be same as like buying every month. Okay? So EMI option is available. And also the most important thing, don't forget that here GPE Pro is mentioned, that will give you extra 10% off. Any other doubt, guys, you have, which I was not able to answer, you can go to the bottom of this page, which is frequently asked questions, and you can answer to all these questions. You can get your answer for any of the questions. Okay, guys. Okay. Now moving ahead, let's solve some more amazing questions. So next question is, find the sum of first n terms of an AP whose nth term is 5 minus 6n. Find the sum of its first 20 terms. Dekho. Ab here beta, sum of n terms they are asking, and they have given nth term. So we all know if nth term is given, which is 5 minus 6n, we can find out all the terms. So a1 will be equal to 5 minus 6 into 1, which is 5 minus 6, which is equal to minus 1. a2 is equal to 5 minus 6 into 2, which is 5 minus 12, which is equal to what beta? Minus 7. Now I know a2, I know a1. I can clearly say it's a common difference. The common difference is a2 minus a1, which is minus 7 minus of minus 1. So minus 7 plus 1, which is equal to minus 6. Beta, I have told you very well. We know the first term. We know the common difference. Find out anything you can want about that AP. We want sum of first 20 terms. That means S20, it will be 20 by 2, n by 2 into 2 into a, which is minus 1, plus n, which is 20 minus 1 into d, which is minus 6. So 20 by 2 is 10 into 2 into minus 1 is minus 2. 20 minus 1 is 19. Now you have to do 19 into minus 6. So when you will do 19 into minus 6, it will be equal to 95 and then minus 114. All right, so minus 114, so it will be equal to 10 into minus 116, which is minus 1160. This will be the sum of first 20 terms. So you can see the first part is very basic. Once the nth term is given, we have done it in the previous session also, nth term is given, you can find out all the terms. And once we have got all the terms, the sum of 20 terms, n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So find out, always focus, whatever questions are there, focused on first term and the common difference. You will find out everything about that AP. Okay? Now look at this question. How many terms of this AP, listen to very carefully, beta. How many terms of this AP मस्ट बी एडेड टू गेट द सम जीरो. भाई सिंपल सी बात है बेटा, इट इज आस्किंग यू हाउ मेनी टर्म्स एस एन, वॉट इज एन, हाउ मेनी टर्म्स आई शुड एड सो दैट एस एन बिकम्स इक्वल टू जीरो. एंड हियर ऑब्वियसली इन दिस क्वेश्चन वी डोंट नो हाउ मेनी टर्म्स, सो एन इज अननोन टू अस. नाउ हियर आई हैव सीन फर्स्ट टर्म इज 21 एंड कॉमन डिफरेंस इज ए टू माइनस ए वन. गाइज प्लीज रिमेंबर it is a decreasing AP, so common difference is negative, which is minus 3. So I can say sum of n terms is equal to 0. Sum of n terms formula is n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d is equal to 0. I know a and I know d, only thing I want to find out is n. Theek hai beta? So it will be n by 2 into 2 into 21 is 42 plus n minus 1 into minus 3 is equal to 0. So you have got n by 2 into 42 plus, sorry, not plus, minus 3 into n beta. Minus 3 into n is minus 3n. Minus 3 into n is minus 3n, and minus 3 into minus 1 is plus 3 is equal to 0. Ab dekho beta, if I shift this 2 over there, 2 into 0 will go in multiplication. 2 into 0 is 0 only. So we have got n into 42 plus 3 is 45 minus 3n is equal to 0. So this is a factorization. This is a factorization. So I can say two values over here, sir. Either n is equal to 0 or 45 minus 3n is equal to 0. So it will be getting 3n is equal to 45 and n is equal to 15. Ab beta dekho, one thing I am very clear about, we know n equal to 0 will not be acceptable because n belongs to natural number. The values of n possible are only natural number. So my correct answer will be n equal to 15. We have to add 15 terms of this AP such that sum of 15 terms will be equal to 0. How good question it is. Dekho, all questions which I am going to give you, all questions will be of different types. Theek hai? Next question dekho. Sum of first n terms of an AP is minus 150 and sum of next 10 terms of an AP is minus 550. Find the AP. So, yahan pe na beta, this is very important to understand what is sum of first 10 terms and what is sum of its next 10 terms. Sum of first 10 terms means A1 plus A2 plus A3 up to A10. Ye up to A10 jo hai na beta, it is given as minus 150. तो ये तो नथिंग बट एस टेन है ना, स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम फर्स्ट टर्म टिल द टेंथ टर्म यू आर एडिंग. सो एस टेन इज गिवन एज माइनस 150. ठीक है, सेकेंड इज गिवन टू यू एज नेक्स्ट 10 टर्म्स. आफ्टर 10 द नेक्स्ट 10 टर्म्स, दैट मीन्स ए 11 प्लस ए 12 प्लस ए 13 अप टू ए 20 इफ आई विल राइट, इट इज इक्वल टू माइनस 550. Now what many students think, ki, aray sir, A20, this is S20, but it is not S20. Guys, remember, S20 means starting from A1 till A20. But here I'm starting from A11. Right or wrong? So it is not S20, but I know ki sir, S20, sum of 20 terms will be nothing, but starting from A1, A2, hai na, till one point will reach up to A10. Yes or no? Yes or no? Correct. Plus A11, A12 up to A20. This will be S20. Right. Now guys, the important thing is I know this A1 plus A10. A1 up to A10 is minus 150. And I also know what is A11 to A20, which is minus 550. So I can say very well that sir, S20 will be equal to A1 plus A2 plus A3 up to A10, which is minus 150, plus A11 plus A20 plus A30 will be equal to what? Will be equal to minus 550. So adding these two, sum of first 10 terms and next 10 terms, when I add these two, that time I can say S20 will be equal to minus of this 600, 700. 0 जीरो से व्हाट आई एम राइटिंग यार, माइनस ऑफ 700. सो दीज आर माई टू इंपॉर्टेंट इक्वेशन, इक्वेशन टू एंड इक्वेशन वन, बिकॉज दीज टू विल गिव मी माई इक्वेशन राइट. सो इक्वेशन वन इफ आई विल राइट इट इन द फॉर्मूला फॉर्म, इफ आई राइट इट इन द फॉर्मूला फॉर्म, इक्वेशन वन इन द फॉर्मूला फॉर्म, वॉट इट विल बी बेटा 10/2, एस 10 इज 10/2 इंटू 2a प्लस 10-1 विच इज 90 इज इक्वल टू -150. ठीक है, टू टू जा टू फाइव जा शिफ्ट फाइव इन डिविजन, 2a प्लस 90 इज -150 बाय 5 इज इक्वल टू -30. फर्स्ट इक्वेशन ऑल राइट सर. सेकेंड इक्वेशन, यूज द सेकेंड इक्वेशन. सेकेंड इक्वेशन गाइज, इफ आई एम यूजिंग द सेकेंड इक्वेशन, तो देखो सेकेंड इक्वेशन में क्या होगा. सेकेंड इक्वेशन, इक्वेशन नंबर टू, आई विल से सम ऑफ 20 टर्म्स, 20/2 इंटू 2a प्लस 19d इज इक्वल टू -700. दिस टू दिस गॉट कैंसल 10 टाइम्स, शिफ्ट 10 इन डिविजन, 2a प्लस 9d -700 बाय 10 विल बी इक्वल टू -70. दीज आर सॉरी 19d, दीज आर माई टू इक्वेशन. लीनियर इक्वेशन टू वेरिएबल, लेट सॉल्व दोज. सो आई हैव 2a प्लस 19d इज इक्वल टू -70 एंड इक्वेशन वन गिव मी 2a प्लस 9d इज इक्वल टू -30. लेट्स डू वन थिंग गाइस, लेट अस सब्ट्रैक्ट. सो इफ आई सब्ट्रैक्ट माइनस माइनस प्लस, दिस गॉट कैंसल, 19 माइनस 9 इज 10d, -70 प्लस 30 इज -40. So D is equal to -4, right? I got to know beta D is equal to -4. Let's find out the value of A by putting this value in any of the equation. Let's say in the first equation if I put it. ठीक है? तो first equation I have 2A plus 9D is equal to -30. Put D is equal to -4 in this. So 2A, 9 into -4 is -36 is equal to -30. So 2a is equal to -36, shifted there will become +36. -30 plus 36 is 6. So a is equal to 3. A is equal to 3, d is equal to -4. So I can see my AP will be 3. 3 plus -4 will be -1. -1 plus -4 is -5, -9, and so on. This is my AP. Theek hai guys? This will be my AP. So two equations I have to get. The important thing is S20 will be A1 plus A2 plus A3 up to A10 plus A11 plus A20 up to A20. So both the terms I need to add to get this answer, and my AP I'll be getting as 3 minus 1 minus 5 minus 9 and so on. So first term is 3, common difference is -4. Alright, now coming to our best question, our most important question. Most important question, beta. What it is saying, it is given in an AP. It is given in an AP, S5 plus S7 is equal to 167, S10 is equal to 235. Theek hai? They are asking you, find the AP where Sn denotes the sum of first n terms. Theek hai? Toh, it's simple si baat hai, beta. We need to find out the AP. Yahan pe. So they have given already given two equation, S5 plus S7 and S10. So directly beta, agar S5, S10, if I use the formula, I can easily get the answer directly. Theek hai? So S5 plus S7 is equal to 167 given. S5 will be 5/2 into 2a plus 5-1, 4d plus S7, 7/2 into 2a plus 7-1 plus 6d is equal to 167. Ab dekho, here in both the brackets you can get 2 common, a plus 2d, and here plus 7/2. Here also if you get 2 common, a plus 3d is equal to 167. Dekho, this cancelled, this to this got cancelled. 5 into a plus 2d is 5a plus 10d, and here 7a plus 21d is equal to 167. 5 plus 7 what beta? 12a. 10 plus 21 plus 31d is equal to 167. This is my first equation. Equation number two, S10 they are asking. तो भाई जी, S10 will be very easy for us. S10 will be is given as 235. So it will be 10 by 2 into 2a plus 10 minus 1, 90 is equal to 235. All right, 2 ones are and here it will be 5 times. So you got 2a plus 90 is equal to 235 upon 5. So 5 fours are 20, remainder 7, 47. This is your second equation. Now obviously our linear equation in two variable is given, let's solve both. So equation one I will write as it is. ठीक है, 12a plus 31d as 167. Equation two what I'll do, I'll multiply this equation with 6. So it will be 12a, 6 2 into 2 is 12a. 9 6 are 54d is equal to 6 into 47. So 6 7 are 42 power 4, 6 4 are 24 plus 4 is 28. Now do the subtraction, minus minus minus, this got cancelled. 31 minus 54 if you will do beta, it will be equal to 9 plus 10 plus 4, so it is around 23. 11 minus 4 if I'll do. Okay, 54 minus 31 it is na, ha. So obviously 23 it is what I'm doing, 23d, and that is negative. And here 282 minus 167, 12 minus 7 will be 5. All right, then here 7 minus 6 will be equal to 1, and here also 1. So d is equal to, it is, and it is also negative. So d is equal to minus 115 by minus 23, which means equal to plus 5. So common difference is 5. Common difference kya hai beta? Common difference is 5. First term, put it in any of the equations. Suppose second one. Second equation, 2a plus 9d. Second equation, 2a plus 9d is equal to 47. ठीक है? So I can say sir, 2a. What is 2a? So a I don't know, but d I have got just now as 5. So 9 into 5 is equal to 47. So 2a plus 45 is equal to 47. You got to know 2a is equal to 2, a is equal to 1. So my first term is 1, common difference is 5. I can say my AP is 1. 1 plus 5, 6. 6 plus 5, 11. 11 plus 5, 16. Then 21, and so on. So every question, beta, it is very important to think about the first term and the common difference. And remember, SN means, very important from this topic, SN means starting from the first term till the nth term. All right, so the last two questions are very important from your exam point of view. The last two questions very important, as well as the first question also. So do practice these questions, guys. All right, and I'm giving you one homework question right now, but before I give you the homework question, I would like all of you to please like this video, share this video, yaar. If you have enjoyed this question, such an amazing question we have done, nothing will go for you. Just like this video and comment us how do you like this video. If there is any question which you would like to take us in the one shot, I will try to take those questions which you want me to solve. If those is a different kind of question, I will take that in one shot videos as well. All right, beta. Now this is your homework question. Do solve this question to get your name in the next session of Vedantu, and you'll be called our homework stars. All right, guys. So this is your homework question. Do attempt this, and you know you'll give me your answer in the comment section. All right, bacho. So this is all in today's class. I have already told you about Vedantu Pro subscription. Just go to the link which is mentioned in the description box of this video, as well as in the pinned comment. And GPE Pro will give you 10% off, which will be the minimum price at which you will be getting this courses. You have three courses, Pro Lite, Pro Classic, Pro Plus. Classes are same, but only difference is in the features. All right. And just don't think ki bacha, this is the price you are paying only for, say, completing your syllabus once. No, because you have unlimited micro courses also. So with the help of this, you can attend these courses, attend the say learn a chapter as many times as you want, study a chapter as many times as you want. All right, and then guys, we have Vedanta Improvement Promise, which will take the guarantee of your improvement. If you don't improve, take the whole course fee back. All right, guys. So thank you so much. See, the batches are starting very soon, but don't wait. Ki when the batch will start? Okay, the batch is starting in July. I'll take it in July only. No, don't do that. Take it right now so that whatever duration you have got in that, you can do the revision. You can go for the micro courses and meet different teachers. Right, you can create the bonding so that you'll become comfortable with them. That is very important. All right, guys. So don't forget to take go for the link which is mentioned in the description box of this video as well as in the pinned comment. Thank you so much, guys. I hope all of you enjoyed this class, and obviously I'll see you soon in the next class. Don't forget to like this video, share the video with your friends, and subscribe to this channel. I'll see you soon. Till then, bye bye. Sayonara, khuda hafiz to all of you. Bye bye, guys.